The President Bush ultimately led America into this war with an approval rating more than 60%. He also was backed by a congressional resolution. Only one Republican did not go along with that resolution. And we're joined now by Senator Lincoln Chafee of Rhode Island. Senator, thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.
What are your thoughts now as America is engaged in this war that you so opposed?
Well, I do assume that we're going to be successful. Secretary Powell testified to one of our Senate Foreign Relations Committee that the Iraqi army is a third of what it was during the Gulf War, and that was over quickly. So with that, I think we can assume that this should be very successful. We're certainly praying and hoping it is.
What do you take from the fact that the air raids in Baghdad so far have been rather isolated and pinprick, if I can use that term?
Well, I do think that we're going into this with a lot of knowledge and superior firepower. And as I said, I think we've got a lot of armaments on our side, and we're prepared to be very, very victorious. And I think that's the direction we're going.
You sound upbeat, and you seem to be convinced that the goals will be attained. But is your opposition to the idea of going to war still as firm?
Yes, I think the fracturing of our hard-fought alliances that we built up over the last 50 years are a serious ramification to the overall fight against terrorism and the continuing challenges we're going to have, whether it's in Afghanistan or North Korea. We're going to need our friendly countries helping us, and not only with North Korea and Afghanistan, as I said, but fighting terrorism around the world.
Do you think the extent of damage, if there is, in that relationship will depend on the length of this conflict and how quickly the U.S. can be successful?
I think a lot of it has to do to how we conduct ourselves, the attitude we have with these countries. And there are serious rifts right now. It can be repaired with good diplomacy, and I hope we return to that. Certainly some of the provocative language has been very harmful.
And what about your language? Are you ratcheting it down because U.S. troops now are on the line?
Well, yes, I'm very concerned. I continue to express my opposition, but I've said all along I thought this would be successful. It's the long-term ramifications of what we're doing here and the different course we're taking than we've ever taken before with such high visibility in such a country departing from the United Nations, going in preemptively. These are big departures from how the United States has conducted itself on the world stage for many years.
That said, is there a certain part of you that welcomes the fact that there may be an end game, no matter how that end game comes about, to this 12 years of standoff with Iraq?
Well, what concerns me most is if the pattern we see applied to Iraq, that is abandoning of our alliances and a willing to be very preemptive without any real evidence of weapons of mass destruction. There was a lot of rhetoric, but there was no evidence of weapons of mass destruction. I don't think anyone would argue that. We saw the aluminum tubes, and that turned out not to be really associated with nuclear weapons. And then the talk about the various other capacities for weapons of mass destruction, they weren't proven. But if we see this pattern and then try to apply it to North Korea, preemptive strikes, abandoning of alliances, we're in for a much bigger scrap as we face North Korea.
And are you prepared for the fact that the U.S. could, as a result of this military action, find that evidence that was so elusive to inspectors?
That remains to be seen, and then we'll have to decide what kind of is to us. Are they locally administered chemical weapons that were never really a threat to us here in the United States? And in conjunction with those countries that border Iraq that originally were so opposed to our intervention there, Jordan, even Kuwait, the Turks, of course, the Saudis, all opposed to this from the beginning. And then, of course, they came on our side as the more we pushed it. But from the initial start, they were against us. And how that, whatever we find, how much of a threat it might be, not only to those friendly allies on the border, but to us many thousands of miles away.
And Senator, you seem to be rejecting the notion that this was a national security issue. What do you think about the president's, even the name of this mission, Iraqi Freedom, the notion that it will free the Iraqi people?
Well, I think it's more my own opinion is that it was about regime change from the beginning, and we're seeing really the fortification of a doctrine that many of those in the administration have talked about for the last 10 years, and that is to be preemptive and to stamp out threats before they become greater to us. And when they see a threat, the doctrine says we move in quickly and if necessarily unilaterally. And we're seeing that here. And again, that concerns me about where we go elsewhere in the world, whether it's in Iran, which might have nuclear weapons, and certainly North Korea that does.
Senator Lincoln Chafee, thank you for taking the time to speak with us today. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.